Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'm making lamb pot pies with biscuit. This is the perfect dish for this season. It's very simple and very easy. Let's get started. I've got some lamb cut into cubes. I'm going to season with salt and pepper and I'm going to coat this in oil. You want to generously coat this in oil on all sides. At the same time, you want to make sure that all the excess flour is dusted off, otherwise you will have a very gloppy oil when you are trying to sear it. Next, I'm going to put a Dutch oven on high with a little bit of oil. You can also use a heavy bottom skillet and add a few pieces at a time so that you get a sear on all sides. If the meat is stuck to the pan, do not try to force remove it, just give it a few more minutes and it will automatically release itself once it kind of gets a nice caramelization and sear. So once you have this done on one side, you turn it around and you do it on the other side. Then you're going to remove it and put the next batch. You want to do this in batches because you want to sear the meat and not stew it. If you add too many, the temperature is going to go down and the meat is going to release all the juices. You want to make sure that that does not happen. To the same pan, I'm going to add oil. The remaining oil, then I'm going to garlic, onion, carrots and celery. Going to saute these for about 2 minutes until the onions are nice and translucent. Once the onions are translucent, we are going to add the brown sugar. Brown sugar, you want to make sure that it is nicely caramelized because it gives us not just color but also flavor. You want that nice caramelized flavor to this. Next, we're going to add in the red wine and deglaze the pan. You want to make sure that you deglaze the pan from all the meat juices that were stuck to the bottom of the pan. Make sure you get it all out and then boil the wine for about 2 minutes. This is going to cook out all the alcohol in the red wine. Next, I'm going to add in crushed tomatoes and the balsamic vinegar. Next, we are going to season this with some salt and pepper and return the lamb back to the pan with all the juices. I'm going to give that a good stir and then add the stock. With the stock, I'm also going to add in some rosemary and thyme. I'm using fresh, but if you don't have fresh, you can also use some dried. Now all we need to do is cover the pan so that everything is nicely cooked for about an hour and a half. In between, you want to make sure that you stir it and so that it does not stick to the bottom and is not too dry. If you find that it is too dry, you can add about half to half one cup of water as necessary. You see how this meat should be fork tender like this. Now you can serve this like that. I'm going to make mini pot pies today, so I'm going to fill my ramekins with some meat and some of the gravy. I'm going to put that aside and start with the biscuits. My oven is already preheating. I'm going to put the flour, salt, pepper, sugar and give that a good mix. I'm going to add the butter. This is cold chilled butter which is cubed. Using the pastry blender, but you can use a fork. I prefer not to use a food processor, but if you prefer a food processor, you can also use a food processor. Next, once you have nice coarse breadcrumb consistency, you can add the egg and give that a good mix. The egg is going to give us a nice rich flaky texture. Next goes in the milk. The milk is going to help bind everything together. Notice that I'm using the fork rather than my hands, just so that the warmth of my hands does not make the butter all soft. Now for the layers, I'm going to kind of pat this down, roll it up a bit and fold it. The layers comes with these folding. We're not going to add any butter inside, but we are going to fold it, and this is going to give us a nice flaky layered biscuit. So I did it once. I'm going to do the same thing one more time. You can do it more than two times, but I personally prefer just about two or maximum three times. I'm going to do that one more time before I roll these and make biscuits. I'm going to square this off a bit and roll it again. You can roll it to about 1/2 to 3/4 inch. The thicker you make it, the longer it takes to bake and the more layers you will have. Next, you want to use a cookie cutter that is similar to the size of your ramekin, or you can also use an upside down ramekin and as a guide. And I'm making biscuits the same size as the ramekin. You can make them slightly smaller than that. And you want to top each ramekin with a biscuit and brush it with milk. Put it into the oven and bake it until it's nice and golden. This is very simple and very easy. I hope you enjoy this recipe. Don't forget to take the link from below this video and visit my blog. My blog has progress pictures and more details for you. And I hope you will visit my blog. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you like the video, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos from me. Don't forget to hit like on this video as well. Bye-bye for now.